Sports welcomes you to the following presentation of the NBA.
New Orleans, the Big Easy. That's the site for the Suns. The veteran floor general, Chris Paul. With his playmaking and leadership, he knows what must be done as they get ready to tip off here in New Orleans, Louisiana. Suns, Pelicans. Round one of the NBA playoffs. All right, you can join us. It's game four of the Western Conference quarterfinals live on 2K Sports. Kevin Harlan here, and I'm joined by Greg Anthony and Clark Kellogg with David Aldridge on our sideline. DA, take it away.
Kevin, thank you. Last season with the Pelicans, Brandon Ingram became a star. Often his own toughest critic, Ingram said, "My motivation is being the best I can be. I can't be perfect, but if I do all I can, I think I can be close to perfect." Kevin, he's putting in the work to get as close as he can. Back to you.
He is indeed, D.A. Thank you. So the opening lineup for the Suns. Booker and Bridges are the wings. Ayton is out there with Jay Crowder, and it's Paul in at the point guard. And for the Pelicans, Ingram the three and Zion the four. All out there at Bledsoe, and it's Adams in at center, locking down the middle. So the Pelicans win the tip. And here is Ball. Passes it to Williamson. Ingram outside. The offensive rebound. Bridges with the steal. To the paint. Stolen by Ball. And Bledsoe has it in the corner. To the inside. And Adams hits it to go down on the assist from Eric Bledsoe.
So good to see Bledsoe setting up guys like that. I mean, especially when they're wide open and they've got the better shot.
Williamson against Crowder. Just five on the clock. Shoots the three. Here's Ayton. And the rebound paying off as they pick up two on the second chance bucket right there.
A towering presence on the offensive glass. Ayton uses his height well to keep possessions alive.
Pass to Bledsoe. From deep. Rebounded by DeAndre. On offense, here are the Suns. They'd like to continue the success they had on Friday night here.
And you've got to love a team that can maintain its composure on the road. Take good shots and knock them down with confidence.
Well, efficiency is critical, and I love how they ran their offense and got quality shots out of their sets.
Here's Ball. After Mikal Bridges' bucket, Ball finds Ingram. It's hauled in by the Suns.
You know, right now they're just 1 for 5. Rough start so far.
He muscles it in through the contact, and they call the foul. He's on his way to the free throw line.
Chris Paul's so good at working for his point. Even if the defense is on his back, challenging him, he still finds a way to finish.
For New Orleans, they've gone just 1 for 5 from the field to start the quarter. Williamson in the post, defended by Crowder. And that one's good, Williamson.
And Williamson, such a unique prospect from a physical standpoint, can get anything he wants in that paint.
And Paul gets it to go in. Paul's got his second bucket of the night.
And they've scored several times already here in the first quarter on the inside.
Ingram outside. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul. That one on Ayton.
And Ingram, the former Blue Devil, an extraordinary player who only promises to get better and better.
This is his first free throw of the game.
Take a break. Two shots.
First free throw is good. Good on both.
He's as solid as it gets from the line. I mean, give him the opportunity, he's cashing in on those.
Here's Paul.
Eric Bledsoe grabs the miss.
Well, you know he wants that one back. I mean, more often than not, he'll sink that mid-range jumper. It does not get much easier than that, but somehow he came up empty there.
And Booker kicks to Bridget. So the wing on the left. Ayton dishes to Crowder. Uses the glass to finish the layup.
Totally unselfish play there from Ayton. Sends the ball to someone with a wide open look.
Bledsoe outside. The pass to Williamson. Let's it go from 14 and misses it off the right side of the rim. Bridges finds Paul. Shoots over Ball. Excellent D there from Ball. Pelicans trail by 5. Bledsoe.
You know, it's never easy or simple trying to slow down Bledsoe. I mean, when he's in attack mode, it puts the defense in a real pickle.
And let's get your take, guys, on a scoring breakdown for the Suns.
You know, guys, we've really seen them do a lot of damage in the paint so far.
And also another aspect of their game that's been super so far tonight is how they've been sharing the basketball.
And the first one at the line is good.
And the key for Bledsoe, like it is for most players, is staying motivated and engaged. I mean, he's a big player for this team, an important player for this team.
Frank Kaminsky, he's checked in for 8. And good on the second, so he makes them both. Phoenix leading by 3. Booker outside. Pass to Bridges. Shot clock at 6. Yep, that one goes in there.
He's somebody that's really comfortable carrying the offensive load.
Passes it to Ingram. Down low. Here's Adams. Connects on the open J. Adams has got his second basket of the night.
Nothing seems to phase Adams, even when you get physical with him.
Crowder kicks to Booker. Kaminsky, the pass to Booker. Back to Kaminsky. Bridges with it. The shot. It's good from the top of the key. Bridges has got 6. And here's Ball. He'll bring it up for the Pelicans. Trailing by 5. Pass to Ingram. Beyond the arc. Jay Crowder with the rebound. For Phoenix, they've gone 7 of 11 in the game. And no good. Some solid defense from Ingram. And it's Ball in the corner. His first shot coming late. Here's Williamson. And there's the bucket. Stay with it on the offensive glass, getting it done. Williamson's got his second bucket. Booker looking around. A pass to Crowder. Inside, Ball, and it's blocked.
Ball's size and timing, really an asset when it comes to him blocking shots.
Every team looking to get easy ones in transition.
I think one of the best ways, guys, to score in transition is that quick hitter after the first burst.
Now here's Booker. He's gotten some minutes, but nothing on the board yet. Phoenix, no good that time either.
I don't think he's performing up to his own expectations, but they still find themselves out in front.
Great idea to pull up and take the transition 3 there. The D was in position to block his path to the hoop if he took it inside.
And first time out of the game called for Phoenix.
They're trying to stem the tide here.
Yeah, you know, they had to do something, anything to stop this run. You can't just let it go on any longer.
So for the Suns, Sharks checked in for Crowder. Torrey Craig comes in for Mikal Bridges. And it's Payne in for Paul. Now here's Payne. Pass to Craig. Charge outside. Phoenix, no good that time either. New Orleans is gone. 1-of-3 from beyond the arc so far in the game. It's blocked.
Like watching Saric make his presence felt with blocks like these.
Ball with it. Working on Payne. Hart, no good. Suns trailing. Here's Craig. And Booker kicks to Payne. And he can't stop the run as he misses. Pelican shooting in his first quarter, around 38%. They're looking a bit creaky out there.
I really think it's important that that shot becomes part of ball. He's got to get comfortable knocking down the three-point shot.
Here's Craig. He's been quiet so far. Still no points in the game. To the left wing.
Really got to put those away, especially against soft interior defense.
Here's Johnson. He can't get that one. The Suns go the other way with it. Payne kicks to Craig. Now here's Payne. Defense right on him. Sharks looking around. Phoenix needs to get off his shot. Craig, good.
Obviously a total team player. Saric is a guy, if his teammate is open, he's going to get the ball.
Now, here's Ball. And that one is good. Ball's got five.
And they've done well at taking advantage of some late defensive rotations and getting the ball in the paint.
Kaminsky kicks to Booker. From 13, off the left rim and out. Pelicans leading by four. Comes out of the gate empty. He's 0 for 1. It's Payne with the ball. He'll bring it up for the Phoenix Suns. Craig can't get it to go.
You know, he looks a little off kilter to me this quarter. Still trying to find his rhythm.
Back to Johnson. Outside Ball.
I tell you, that was double duty right there. He influenced the shot and then got back and cleaned the glass.
Here's Craig. He's covered by Ball. Payne with it. He's still scoreless so far in this one. Here's Booker, and he hits it just before the shot clock expires.
Not just an outside shooter. Booker is also skilled at getting it done from that area as well.
And first time out of the game called for New Orleans.
Trying to find some answers offensively.
Yeah, and you know, that's going to be the focus of this timeout. They need to come up with a spark to get the offense going.
Gomez has checked in for James Johnson. And the Suns also making a change. Johnson, he's checked in for Frank Kaminsky. 1:39 left in the first. Pass to Hart. Pass to Ball. Clock at four. Fires the three. Hernan Gomez. He hangs in there and cashes in on the second chance points.
Already, they've staked out a noticeable advantage in terms of aggression and controlling the backcourt.
And the trend they'd love to continue right through the next three quarters as well.
Payne kicks to Sharic. And it's off from three-point range. To the paint, here's Ball, and that one drops for him. Now it's a 6-point Pelican lead.
Well, we've seen that movie a few times, haven't we? An easy bucket in the paint.
Well, listless and lifeless at the defensive end. I mean, especially inside. They've really got to pick up that interior defense.
Here's Hart. Ball, the pass to Alexander Walker. Good work defensively by Johnson. Suns trail by 6. Here's Craig. Payne passes to Craig. Back to Payne. Off on the layup.
You know, you don't always get that opportunity, so those are the ones you hate to miss.
And so it's the New Orleans Pelicans with a 6-point lead at the end of the quarter. A terrific tempo and a great pace. The fast break has been a central part of their offense. And we'll be back with you shortly. To the art of providing leadership, CP3 have this to say.
The guys on the team already tell me I talk too much a lot. You know, I'm constantly talking on the court. Just, I'm a communicator, and I feel like it's hard to go wrong when you're communicating.
Well said. He does a great job of keeping everyone involved and on the same page.
And Kevin, he practices what he preaches. He plays the right way and motivates his teammates to do the same.
And we welcome you back to Game 4 on 2K Sports. And looking at what we've seen from the Pelicans, what do you guys think?
Well, one way to generate more offense, pound the offensive glass. That was the difference in the first.
Well, there's no doubt about it, guys. Without those second chance points, this game would have had a much different feel to it.
He's out there with Brandon Ingram. Then there's Hernan Gomez, and it's Hart in at the 2. So that's the group out there for New Orleans.
Sweet find there by Booker. All eyes on him with the ball. And Devin understands that. It has a nice feel for giving up the rock.
Here's Payne. The Pelicans make their last shot. Ayton dishes to Booker. Yep, that one goes.
Against Booker, a little contact usually doesn't go a long way. Strong body control there.
First trip to the free throw line for him tonight. Williamson is checked in for the Pelicans. And for the Suns, Jay Crowder comes in for Šarić. And Paul subbed in for Payne. Free throw, good, Booker.
An accurate shooter from all areas of the floor. Booker has the confidence needed to dominate on offense.
And that one's good, Williamson.
And they haven't been able to turn it into a big lead, but their rebounding advantage is starting to add up.
Yeah, still close, but with their tough play on the board, we're certainly seeing the effort.
A shot by Paul, no good.
He is single-handedly dropping the temperature in here with that cold streak.
And he's got to find other ways to contribute then, because his shot-making is not happening right now.
You see the playmaking ability of Williamson there. Great pass to set up his teammate.
And a chance to catch up on some numbers here. Scoring breakdown for New Orleans.
It looks like they're ready to run, fellas. I mean, they haven't hesitated at all to get out on the break so far.
And it doesn't look like they'll be giving up on any plays tonight either. Their offensive rebounding has also been equally as impressive.
Now here's Johnson. No points in the game yet for him. Here's the pass to Paul. Takes the 13-footer, and the rebound goes to the Pelicans. Alexander Walker's got 4 rebounds now tonight. Count it. Williamson's got the lead up to 10 now for New Orleans.
No doubt about the consistency when it comes to scoring the basketball for him tonight. A real nice lift for their offense.
Now here's Crowder. Pass to Bridges. And the Suns miss again.
And he didn't punish them for the weak coverage there, but they can't count on him to continue missing.
And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line.
tell you what, he earned his money on that foul.
Yeah, if you're going to foul, then make sure that you don't give a chance for the and one.
He's getting his first free throw attempt of the night right now.
Two shots.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
First one falls for. That's also good. So he hits both free throws.
And they have yet to miss a shot from the line here this quarter.
Yeah, you have to make teams pay for fouling you. That's why they call them free. And they've done exactly that. Made them pay.
And he comes up with the deuce. Paul's got his third basket of the night right there.
Tell you what, that mid-range game from Chris Paul, he's really an assassin from there. You can see less and less of that shot in this day and age, but CP got the green light to shoot it.
But the edge on the glass is the difference. It's allowed them to build this lead.
And really a reflection of their superior effort level to this point. It seems to me they've gone after this win a little bit more.
Just such strength on these finishes. When you foul Aiden, you really have to hit him to prevent the basket.
And he's got his first chance at the line here.
And you see the raw talent Aiden has, an intimidating big man with a high ceiling and a desire to grow.
To the inside, here's Williamson. It's in and good for his sixth field goal in 10 attempts.
And not hard to see why they are giving up points on this run. Just too many good looks from in close.
Crowder kicks to Bridges, and he's good on the three ball. Bridges has got 9 points.
A total defensive collapse. I mean, no reason to allow him that kind of space from behind the arc.
Here's Ingram in the hoop for his fourth field goal. 4 for 7 shooting and looking for more.
Virtually unfair. Actually, I'd say it is unfair for a 6'9" guy like Ingram to handle the pumpkin like that.
He just punched the ticket on that one. That'll get the job done.
Powerful two-hand jam.
I tell you what, if he's got a few more of those in him, this lead will really start shrinking.
Williamson finds Bledsoe. Offensive rebound. And so it's Johnson who brings the ball up for the Suns. In the corner, it's Bridges. Here's Crowder. That shot off. Bledsoe with a defensive effort. Williamson, the pass to Ingram. Out left to the wing. New Orleans moving the ball around. To the middle, here's Alexander Walker. 2 points, that one goes. And the Pelicans lead by 10.
Those defenders just look a little bit gassed. I mean, they're getting pushed around on that low block.
Timeout called, the Suns. As the teams head into this timeout, a chance for the coaches now to map out some plays for the next few minutes and a chance for the players to rehydrate with some Gatorade. That's important if they want to make sure they don't wear down later in the game.
Absolutely. Over the course of a game, you have to stay hydrated.
He's checked in for the Pelicans. Johnson comes in for Zion Williamson. Kaminsky is checked in for the Suns. There's the call on James Johnson. That's his first foul. A fantastic mobile one block. This one deserves another look.
And it's a different kind of defense teams play in the postseason. More in your face, physical, high energy plays like that one.
past the ball. Now, Kaminsky, guarded by Bledsoe. Bridges kicks to Crowder. Down to five on the shot clock. The tray.
Boy, the long limbs of Ingram come into play on defense, bothering shooters with his length and his hustle.
And it's Phoenix with the rebound. Here's Crowder. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul. The Suns shooting their fourth and fifth attempts at the free throw line tonight. And the first one drops. And the Pelicans making a change here. Ball's checked in. And Phoenix also making a switch. Craig's checked in. And both free throws good from Crowder.
And working, Kevin, themselves to the line here in the second. A nice way to get your offense going.
And maybe cause some foul trouble along the way as well. We know what that can do. It pays off typically in good fashion for you.
Fires the three. Drops in the tray. Crowder's got 7 points.
They're having more success from three-point range here in the second after a rough first quarter from deep.
Ingram finds Adams. Back to Ingram. Jacks up a three. Unable to get that one. The Suns go the other way with it. Here's Craig. He's covered by Ingram. Kaminsky dishes to Crowder. Over Bledsoe. Here's Ayton. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws.
An absolute beast inside. Love how Ayton uses his size to draw these fouls.
The Suns shooting their sixth and seventh free throw attempts tonight. Free throw drops for Ayton. Hart, he's checked in for Brandon Ingram. And Phoenix also making a switch. Payne, he's checked in for Jay Crowder. Ayton hits them both.
And didn't have a single free throw in that first quarter, but he started to play with a little bit more of an edge to his game here in the second.
Ball, the pass to Bledsoe. Johnson kicks to Ball. Back to Johnson. And no good. The dry spell continuing for him. Ball, no one around him. Here's Ayton, fouled in the act of shooting. Gets the bucket anyway, so a three-point play chance for him.
And the size, the wingspan, and the athleticism Ayton has is huge. Very strong at rebounding.
Three trips to the line so far for him in this one. And Phoenix making a change here. Booker's checked in. And it's tied up with that one. And here's Ball. He'll bring it up for New Orleans. Now Bledsoe. He has 5. It's good. Bledsoe's got 7.
Love the toughness of Bledsoe. Outstanding at maintaining his balance, even when you body him up.
Book. Second chance shot. It's stolen by Johnson. Bledsoe with him. Now guarded by Booker. Bledsoe kicks to Johnson. Ball feeling it out a bit. Passes to Bledsoe. Offline with his 3.
Rare you'll see him miss such an open look.
They get it back. Knocked away. And Phoenix turns it over again.
And that's just carelessness there. I mean, you have got to have your head in the game.
Jackson Hayes, he's checked in for the Pelicans. Sharj checked in for the Suns. New Orleans has gone 0-2 from deep here in the south. Bledsoe outside. Ball finds Hayes. Bledsoe with it. Defended by Booker. Back to Hayes. And Hayes throws it down.
Oh, just solid on the one-handed slam.
And guys, when it's a tight ball game like this, he's the guy they want with the ball.
Somebody you can count on. He is an extremely reliable finisher.
Now here's Payne. He's been quiet so far. Still no points in the game.
He's starting to find himself out there now. You know, he's taking much better shots here in the second quarter.
Here's Ball. They lead by one. Rebounded by Kaminsky. Kaminsky's got four rebounds now tonight. Booker in the corner. Stolen by Bledsoe. And now in transition is Bledsoe. Here we go. Hart, no good. Phoenix has gone for the three-pointer seven times here in the second and been successful three times. And they take the lead. Booker's got 10 points in the quarter.
Boy, he's really been on a roll this quarter. Seems like everything he throws up is finding bottom.
Now here's Bledsoe. 7 points in the game.
It's a quiet, rugged demeanor that Bledsoe plays with, and he doesn't back away from anybody on the court.
Now Phoenix shooting 43% from the field. Payne looking around. And Booker kicks to Craig. Here's Payne. Lays it up and banks it in. We've seen the lead change hands quite a bit in this one.
And guys, I think each team knows they can win this game. Just a matter who can catch that momentum.
Now here's Bledsoe. 9 points in the game so far. Good D by Booker. And here's Payne. Pass to Craig. From past the arc. And it's Eric Bledsoe with the rebound. The Pelicans trail. Down low. Hart kicks to Bledsoe. And there it is for him. Bledsoe's got 11 points.
Boy, Hart is one of those guys you look at and you can just see the team is first with him. He never hesitates to find the open guy.
A nice shot by Booker.
Man, he's having quite the quarter, converting at a really high percentage.
New Orleans gone 0-3 from beyond the arc to start the second quarter. A floater rejected by Booker. And it's out of bounds. Last touch by Booker. And the Pelicans making a change here. Williamson's checked in. We've got 28 seconds left now here in the second. And Hayes kicks to Hart. Five to shoot. Williamson trying to free himself up. Bledsoe outside. Tries again. It's deflected. And so it's Devin Booker making highlights for Phoenix. That quarter had to take a lot out of him. He racked up 12 points. We've got more NBA basketball coming your way in just a minute.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
And a heightened atmosphere we have here this evening for NBA playoff action. Hey, everybody, I'm Ernie Johnson. Got Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith by my side. Well, for the Suns, they'll be extremely motivated to come out in the second half and try to secure control. Because it's no secret to anyone that the difference between a 3-1 lead in a series as opposed to being tied 2-2 is massive. Kenny, let's start with you. What did you think about the Suns?
The hostile environment in this building has not been an issue. They come in here, they focus like they would be at home. And it says something about the character of a team. You need to block out the crowd and just play your game.
And over to the big fella, your thoughts on the Pelicans.
Well, their bench production has been a major factor. Guys have been ready to go when their number is called. And it makes the second half go a lot easier on your main guys when you can spread the minutes around in the first half.
And now with the second half about to get underway, let's send you back courtside. See you, everybody, with Kevin Harlan.
again as our round one coverage continues. You know, guys, Devin Booker has been exceptional here.
No problems fighting his way to the rim in this one. A lot of points in close.
Yeah, you know what, guys? They gave him too many free runs to the hoop in the first half. I think they've got to be a lot tougher on him. Body him up. Be physical with him.
Well, it doesn't get much better than playoff basketball. Let's get back to the action here in round one. Getting underway in the second half. Here's the five for Monty Williams. Booker and Bridges are the wings. Jay Crowder out there with Ayton. And it's Paul in at the point. Bridges with it. Now guarded by Ingram. Bridges' shot. Good.
Pick works well there. Not much resistance from the D.
Yeah, that's not the defense you need. You got to be tougher defensively.
Bledsoe against Booker. And the rejection by Ayton.
And using that wide reach to reject shots. Ayton can't afford to throw up weak stuff around the big five.
Paul kicks to Booker. And the pass to Ayton. Ball against Paul. Booker the pass to Ayton. Here's Bridges. Got a lot of room. And now in transition is Bledsoe. Here we go. And that one's good. Williamson. Third quarter, guys, and this has been a neck and neck game.
Both teams getting it done defensively, as evidenced by the 8 lead changes thus far.
Now here's Paul. He has 7. Shoots over Ball. Here's Ayton. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot 2 at the free throw line. It's going to be on Zion Williams.
And at 7'1" and 250 pounds, Ayton is a handful. Not easy trying to guard him without foul.
And it'll be his fourth time going to the free throw line in the game. And the first one at the line is good. Ayton hits them both. The Pelicans have gone 2 of 3 from the field to start the second half. And he could not get that one to go. Out of contact, and he'll go to the line for 2. That one on 8.
Not the last time we'll see that. Adams is so powerful and loves to take it to the defense.
The Pelicans have made the most out of their opportunities at the line. They have yet to miss in 7 attempts. And he makes the first. So he picks up just 1 from the line that time.
They should be in front right now, but he'll be relieved not to have come up totally empty there.
Booker in the corner. And the 3 ball is good. Booker's got 17 now.
And really, Booker is as lethal as they come from deep. Can't allow him to get into a groove.
Adams dishes to Ingram. Phoenix grabs the miss. And up the court come the Suns on the break. Shot by Crowder, no good. Pelicans trail by 3. Ball with it, now guarded by Booker. Ball, the pass to Adams. Yes, that goes in. Adams has got his 3rd bucket of the night.
Ball, such a terrific passer. He seems to have a 6th sense. Nice feel, which is hard to teach.
Phoenix calls timeout.
And team strategies closely guarded. One aspect of the game the fans aren't always privy to.
Yeah, typically there's some type of adjustment made out of a timeout. It might be major, or it could be just a slight tweak.
Pelicans making a switch here. Alexander Walker's checked in. The Suns making a change here as well. Johnson's checked in. Booker the pass to Ayton. Paul with the ball. Now defended by Adams. They get it back.
Defense did a really good job of choking off the middle there once he got inside.
Here's Ingram. And the rejection by Ayton.
This is what you love about Williamson. On the shorter side for a big man, but he's developing the pump fake as an equalizer.
The Pelicans have shot the ball well from the free throw line. 8 of 9.
Taking two shots.
That free throw good from Williamson.
And we first heard about Williamson in high school, and that was due to his dunking ability. Now he's a full-fledged star on the rise.
That one is no good.
And you can see that even though he ties the game up, disappointed he couldn't give him the lead.
Snatched up. And another shot. And Adams sends it back.
Adams puts every ounce of energy into his defense. He's not out there to contest shots. He's out there to reject them.
Ingram passes to Alexander Walker. Here's Adams. A miss that time. Would have put him up.
Boy, patrolling the paint well, protecting the rim. That's exactly the kind of defensive effort you need against him.
Ayton, the pass to Paul. Lead pass was put in just the right spot. Paul's got 9.
And we know Paul's not the biggest guy in the league. Far from it. But that does not stop him from finding ways to score inside.
Now here's Williamson. He's got 15. Oh, he blocked it and deflects off the backboard. Here's Bridges. Here's Ayton. Adams, HD.
And not allowing the shooter even an inch of breathing room on that one.
And guys, that's exactly the kind of high-impact defense they want to see out of him.
Now here's Ingram. He's got 13. A three-pointer is right on target. 16 points for him.
Man, that sure got to be a load off his mind after not getting a single three-pointer in that first half.
Ayton finds Paul. It's blocked. And that's out of bounds. Phoenix will retain possession. His shot was hindered by that momentous Mobile One block.
And bringing that postseason intensity, so key. These plays can change the trajectory of a game.
Hernan Gomez is checked in for Zion Williamson. And a change for the Suns. Sharks checked in for 8. On the clock, and he gets the bucket. Paul's got 4 points in the quarter. A great competitive game so far.
And from the look of it, this one could go right down to the wire.
Ball, the bounce pass. And Adams kicks to Ingram. That shot misses. Good D by Johnson. And here's Sharks. He'll bring it up for Phoenix. It's a 1-point game. Good on the bucket.
And what a baller Booker is, capable of torching you from any spot on the floor.
Ball dishes to Ingram. The 3. And it's Phoenix with the rebound. Here's Bridges. It's rebounded by New Orleans. And Gomez has got 6 rebounds in the game. Paul against Ball. Second shot opportunity, and Hernan Gomez finishes it off. Hernan Gomez has got 6.
That kind of energy and hustle on the glass usually produces good results.
Paul finds Booker. There's the 3. It's hauled in by Adams. Adams has got his 5th rebound in this one. Back to Ball. Pulls up on the elbow. Offensive rebound. shoots a fader. Shot's good by Hernan Gomez.
Well, you can't give him any room to maneuver on the board because once he does, he's going to make you pay.
Johnson, the pass to Booker, and he makes good on the layup. Booker's got 21.
This is a guy who once scored 70 points in a game. Booker doesn't take much for him to start percolating.
Pass to Ingram. And he's fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line. Mikal Bridges picks one up. And a chance to catch up on some numbers here. The hustle stats for the Suns.
Contested shots and block shots. They're bread and butter defensively. They're giving up no easy looks.
And also, guys, they take a lot of pride in their ability to rebound the basketball, especially on the offensive end.
And that one falls for Ingram. New Orleans making some changes here. Hayes comes in for Adams, and Hart subbed in for Lonzo Ball. And then for Phoenix, Kaminsky is checked in for Devin Booker. Torrey Craig comes in for Bridges, and Cameron Payne subbed in for Chris Paul. Both free throws good for Ingram. Phoenix has gone 1-2 from beyond the arc since coming out of the break. Now here's Payne. Inside, Kaminsky. It's good. Kaminsky's got his first 2 points of the night.
And they're passing the ball very crisply here.
Here's Alexander Walker. Rebounded by Kaminsky. They're running. Here's Craig. Finished off the break. Now it's a 3-point Suns lead.
Great teamwork punctuated by a strong finish.
That is the perfect fast break, guys. Getting a hoop before the defense can get set.
No problem knocking that one down. Ingram's got two now from beyond the arc in the third for the Pelicans. Now here's Payne. He started closer. Out to Sharge. But they get it back.
And that's a nice job on the offensive glass there. That'll let them work the clock even more. And now they're starting to pound the basketball inside.
That's going to be over and back. Not watching for the line that time.
You know, guys, sometimes that just happens, but you don't like to see it when the game is this close.
Crowder, he's checked in for the Suns. Here's Payne. Passes it to Šarić. Back to Payne. Kaminsky, the pass to Šarić, makes it off the glass. Šarić has got his first basket.
Yes. Šarić knows he has the touch needed to capitalize inside.
Bledsoe dishes to Hayes. Back to Bledsoe. He gets that one.
Yeah, I love the communication and the chemistry between those teammates.
And so it's Payne with it. He'll bring it up for the Sun. The lead is two. By Ingram.
In addition to being superb on offense, Ingram is also a ridiculously good defender. I mean, his long reach really allows him to come up with a good number of blocks.
Phoenix has gone 1-3 from downtown since halftime. Payne on the post, guarded by Bledsoe, and he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up. For Phoenix, they haven't made a mistake at the line yet. 10 of 10.
Shooting two.
And he knocks down the first one.
And it's been an outstanding game for them at the free throw line, not missing their chances when they get them.
Langston Galloway's checked in for Sharks. Payne hits them both. 1:58 left to play in the third. Ingram outside. Slammed up by Ingram.
Hey, I know Ingram looks a little wispy and light, but his strength is deceptive.
Nice work at the line so far, going 5 for 5. And Phoenix making a change here. Carter's checked in. that one falls for Ingram. The Suns leading. Payne passes to Kaminsky. To Payne. Crowder with it. Now guarded by Bledsoe. Shot by Crowder, no good. New Orleans has gone 2-3 when they ventured outside the arc in the third quarter. Bledsoe kicks to Hayes. Johnson against Crowder. Shot clock at 5. For 3, Bledsoe. It's hauled in by the Suns.
Well, he had 1 3-pointer in the first half, but so far in the second, he's come up with goose eggs.
And for the Pelicans, they're shooting at 44%. Pretty reasonable. Hayes dishes to Ingram. Bledsoe with it. He's got 13. For the lead, it doesn't go for him.
Well, I'll tell you what, he's going to buy himself a ticket to the bench. If he keeps shooting it like that, he has been putrid here this quarter.
Out of bounds, New Orleans will take possession. Williamson is checked in for the Pelicans. Booker, he's checked in for Phoenix. Chris Paul comes in for Cameron Payne. 27 seconds left in the third. Pass to Williamson. Ingram with it. Good, and the assist goes to Williamson. Ingram's got 26.
And with Ingram, he can score from anywhere. I mean, his jump shot is money, and his drives to the hoop, lethal.
And Booker kicks to Paul. And again, it's the Suns missing. It's still anybody's game as we've reached the end of 3. Pelicans ahead, leading by a point. We've got more NBA basketball coming your way in just a minute. And it's time now to bring you our State Farm Assist of the Game.
And the winner today, the big fella here with the sweetest of dimes. What a plus it is to have a post player who's got this ability to find.
Boy, that's a nice asset to have. It's a huge boost to any offense, too. It adds a whole nother dimension when you've got a big guy that can pass.
NBA playoff, round one. Thanks for joining us as we get back to the action on the court. Ingram the 3 and Zion the 4. Hart is out there with Bledsoe, and it's Hayes in at the 5. That's the Pelicans' 5. Here's Hart. He kicks to Bledsoe. 4 on the shot clock. Here's Hayes. It's hauled in by the Suns. Kaminsky's got rebound number 7 for him tonight. That's good from Booker on the assist from Crowder. Booker's got 9 points here in the second half. The pass to Hayes. The dish to Ingram. A shot that time, not on target. Good work defensively by Crowder. Ayton inside. Working on Williamson. And that one's good, Ayton.
And a strong showing of physical strength there from Ayton. Defenders have their hands full when he's around the rim.
Now a timeout called by New Orleans. You gotta like what Devin Booker is doing in this one.
Boy, he's been killing them all night, and the defense looks like it's practically packed it in.
Checked in. On the sideline, let's catch up with Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
During the timeout, I listened in on Stan Van Gundy's huddle. He he's not happy with what he says are late rotations defensively against their three-point shooters. And at the offensive end, he wants his guys to get their own shots within the rhythm and flow of the offense. Kevin?
Bridges, he's checked in for Phoenix. Substitution for the Suns. Fourth quarter now. We're about a minute and a half in. Pike the pass to Hayes. Just five on the clock. Poked away. Deep two from Paul. And that one goes long.
It's almost like he's trying to make things hard on himself. You know, he's just got to slow the game down, try to get some easy ones.
And that one's good, Ayton.
He just looks so fluid in the open floor. I love how Ayton runs to the right spot.
What a jam!
Are you kidding me? Woo! Already such a well-coordinated athlete for his size and age. Williamson bringing down the house.
Booker, and he banks in the layup. Booker's got 11 in the second half.
Coming off a big game, his confidence couldn't be higher, and coach knows it.
Showing no signs of slowing or cooling down. They're going to ride him as far as he can take him.
And the lack of effort to fight over the screen there makes that an easy shot.
Well, I'm going to credit the screen. I mean, that's a good, strong pick he lays there.
Paul outside. Looking to end his cold spell. And the layup is good. Paul's got the lead back up to five now for the Suns. Bledsoe outside. Mr. Williamson. Shoots over Crowder. And that one's good. Williamson. Williamson's got 4 points in the quarter.
And normal physicality doesn't get it done with Williamson. To stop him from scoring, you really have to up the ante and hit him before he hits that launching pad.
High post try, and it hung on the rim, but wouldn't fall for him. And so it's Ball who brings the ball up for New Orleans. Some nice passing here by New Orleans. And he gets the whistle for the 3 second call. Checking in. Phoenix leading by three. Now Booker. Chalk up two there. The Pelicans have gone 3 of 7 from the floor in the fourth. That's a 42% mark in the quarter. Here's Williamson. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here. It's going to be on Jay Crowder.
This is the challenge Williamson possesses to many defenders. Hard to guard him without fouling.
Two shots.
That free throw good from Williamson. And that one goes in. Two from the line that time. Suns leading by three. Timeout call, the Suns.
And he could tell his guys were dragging a little bit, calling timeout to kind of let them catch their breath.
Ladies and gentlemen, dance team.
Nuggets. To the left side wing. To the paint. And it's slammed in by Bridges.
Oh, that's a terrific pass. Aiden, with the advanced skill level, he's just going to get better with time.
And with that, the Phoenix leaders cut down now to just 3 in the bucket from Ball.
A heads-up aggressive play right there. Saw the smaller man on him and took it straight to the basket.
Aiden trying to break free, and he makes that one.
You know, this is why they trust Paul to run the offense. I mean, he's so good at getting the ball to guys on time and on target.
It's tipped. Crowder with the steal. And here we go. Fast break. Paul's got it. Kicks to Booker. Feeds it to Bridges. Good. And a nice assist from Booker. Booker's got 4 assists now tonight.
Assists like that have typified their effort today. Terrific ball movement.
Really a prime example of the difference in how these teams have operated offensively. Much more individual play at the other end.
Bledsoe for 3. Rebounded by DeAndre. Phoenix leading by 7. Pass to Bridges. And it's slammed in by Bridges.
The V just kind of stepping aside and letting him get to the rim.
There's a reason, GA, the lead is what it is right now.
You know, you look at it, the communication is lacking, as is the trust. They can ill afford those types of breakdowns. It won't work. You can't win with those kind of breakdowns.
Free throw drops for Eric Bledsoe. Brandon Ingram, he's checked in for New Orleans. And he makes both free throws. And so Booker will bring it up for the Phoenix Suns. Booker draws the double. Looking for Ayton. He gets it in there. And the whistle blows as the basket counts. And a 3-point play chance right here. 1 free throw coming up.
Just impressed with the teamwork out there. Setting the table for one another.
5 straight baskets resulting from assists. They're playing as one unit.
Free throw, no good. Pelicans trail by 9. 9 feet out. Here's Adams, and there's 2 points. Working on the glass, paying off that time.
You have to put a body on Adams. He's too good of an offensive rebounder to not pay attention.
A nice shot by Booker.
Fantastic ball movement. They're picking them apart with their passing.
Purposeful passing it is, partner. Their last 10 points have all come off assists.
Ball with a wide open look. Good, and the assist goes to Williamson. Ball's got 5 points now this quarter.
Lonzo becoming more consistent with his catch and shoot jumper. I know it doesn't look that good, but it's got a nice touch on it, and it's effective.
The plan of attack is obvious. Get the ball inside and go strong to the rim.
You know, the defense has been very slow to adapt. I mean, that's 10 straight points now inside.
First 3 of the half, 2nd of the game. Can he heat up?
In the corner, it's Bridges. It's not going to go for him. So the Pelicans will take it the other way. Williamson kicks the ball. Bledsoe outside. He feeds it to Williamson. Lock at 6. And the basket is good. Williamson's got 23 points.
And what you love about Williamson, he's not just magnetic and entertaining. He's extremely productive.
That's a 2 from Paul. They grab their own miss. And he'll shoot free throws here. Clearly fouled on that shot that time. The whistle blowing.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
The first free throw is good. Ryan Kaminsky, he's checked in for Jay Crowder. Both free throws good from Booker. Pelicans trail by five. Ball, the pass to Williamson. Here's Ingram. Another one falls for New Orleans.
The nice shooting ability of Ingram makes that mid-range J a quality shot.
Here's Paul. Oh, that's blocked. And New Orleans pushing it up now. Count the bucket, and he's got a free throw coming up as well.
This is why they go to Zion. His teammates trusting in his ability to get the job done.
That one drops. He ties it up.
He's done a much better job of getting to the line here. Aggressively taking it inside and not shying away from contact. I thought he was settling a bit in the first.
An awesome distributor. Booker's floor awareness and understanding of when to dish it is a real weapon.
Ball kicks to Ingram. Ball's knocked loose. Bridges with the steal. Ahead. Ball passes to Ayton. And Ayton throws it down.
He is showing signs of maturity in these moments. It's clear that Ayton takes pride in coming through for his team.
And stolen by Booker. And Phoenix pushing it up now. Over in the corner, Paul. A three-pointer off the mark.
I wonder if switching baskets really threw him off. I mean, because he can't get anything to fall this half.
He misses the free throw. And he's good on the second. And the Suns call time here.
And they're picking up a lot of fouls already in the penalty. Not a good sign. They need to focus on moving their feet and maintaining a good defensive position.
Now a moment to present the New Balance Player of the Game, Devin Booker.
Yeah, and his performance has been a jaw dropper. He must have been feeling great coming into the building tonight, because once he hit the court, it was all working for him. He was in a zone.
Phoenix leading by three. Paul passes to Kaminsky. With three, Booker. The rebound by Brandon Ingram. And so it's Paul who brings the ball up for New Orleans. Dishes it to Ingram. Back to Ball. Misses the three.
And on an open look like that, he's very gifted at making the weak coverage play.
Booker against Bledsoe. And Ayton the bucket on the assist by Booker. Booker's got 6 assists in the game.
Just terrific at executing in the paint. Ayton has a nice array of shots to choose from.
Pass to Ingram. Just 5 to shoot. Ball from long range. Rebounded by DeAndre Ayton. Ayton's got rebound number 17, if you can believe that. And the shot is good.
Timeout.
Now it's a 7-point Suns lead.
Never surprising to see Chris Paul start the break now. But as we see right there, he's just as good at finishing.
Timeout called here. The Pelicans decide to talk it over. They're trailing by 7. 104 left to play here in the fourth. Against Ball, it drops. Oh, and that cuts the lead to just 5.
Boy, he loves taking over in big spots. He doesn't back down, and you can see how much he relishes these moments.
And Booker kicks to Ball. No good on the shot, and it's the Pelicans taking it the other way. Here's Bledsoe. Bridges with the board. And so they choose to intentionally foul. Two seconds left to play in the final quarter. And they go to the intentional foul.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 shots.
First free throw is good, and that increases their lead to 6. So he goes 2 for 2 at the line, and it's a 7-point game.
You know, important for him to come through at the line there because they want to expand that lead.
Timeout called here. The Pelicans decide to talk it over. They're behind by 7. We've got 28 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Seven-second difference, shot and game clock. Ball against Paul. Bledsoe for 3, and it's Phoenix with the rebound. Booker outside. So it's it's Phoenix picking up the win. And now they're sitting on a commanding 3-1 lead. They've grabbed this series by the throat, Greg.
And Kevin, I don't think they're going to let it go. You can see the determination they had tonight. They don't want to drag this series out. They want to get this thing over with.
And that about wraps it up, folks. We hope you've enjoyed our broadcast of the NBA Western Conference Quarterfinals. For David Aldridge, Greg Anthony, and Clark Kellogg, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for being with us. See you next time.